E-Maths class, Fatima Convent High School. Myself, Dipali. Chapter 6, Triangles, class 10. After seeing the two criterias, that is AAA, angle, 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 and side, side, side criteria, let us move to the third one. For that, let us perform an activity. Activity 6. Draw two triangles ABC and DEF such that AB is equal to 2 cm, angle A is 50 degrees, AC is 4 cm, DE is 3 cm, angle D is 50 and DF is 6 cm as seen in the figure. Here if you try to observe side AB, angle BAC and side AC have a relation in which angle A is called the included angle because it is between the two sides. We have already studied this in 9th standard that if the angle is formed between the two sides, then it is said to be an included angle. So if I have these two sides, then this angle is called the included angle. So in this both the triangles, this angle A and angle D is included angle. Now let us observe that AB upon DE is equal to AC upon DF and each is equal to 2 upon 3. An angle A, which is included angle between AB and AC, and is equal to angle D, which is included angle between DE and DF. This is one of the angle in the triangle is equal to one angle of another triangle and sides including these angles are in same ratio, that is proportion. Now let us measure angle B, angle C, angle E and angle F. You will find that angle B and angle E are equal, angle C and angle F are equal. That is, angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E, and angle C is equal to angle F. So, by AAA similarity criteria, triangle ABC and triangle DEF are similar. We may repeat this activity for drawing several pairs of such triangles with one angle of the triangle equal to one angle of another triangle and the sides including this angles are proportional. Every time you will find that the angles are similar. This is due to the following criteria of similarity of triangles. If one angle of a triangle is equal to one angle of the other triangle and the sides including these angles are proportional, then the two sides of the triangle are similar and two triangles are similar. This criteria is referred to as SAS, side angle side similarity criteria for two triangles. As before, this theorem can be proved by taking two triangles ABC and DEF such that AB upon DE is equal to AC upon DF, but this ratio should be less than 1 and angle A is equal to angle D. Now we are cutting DP such that it is equal to AB and DQ which is equal to AC and join PQ. So we get the following figure as 6.8. Now we know that PQ is parallel to EF and triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DPQ. Why it is so? Because we know that these two triangles are already constructed in such a way that AB is equal to DP and AC is equal to DQ and angle A is equal to angle D. So by SAS criteria, it is a congruency and PQ is parallel to EF. Now angle A is equal to angle D and angle B is equal to angle P and angle C is equal to angle Q. So by AAA criteria, triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. All three became equal. Now we take some examples to illustrate the use of these criterias. In figure 6.29, if PQ is parallel to RS, prove that triangle POQ is similar to triangle SOR. So we already know that PQ is parallel to RS, so angle P is equal to angle S, alternate angles, and angle Q is equal to angle R, again alternate angles, and angle POQ and angle ROS are also equal, vertically opposite angles. So by AAA similarity criteria, these two angles, that is triangle POQ, is similar to triangle SOR. Let us see the fifth example. Now, given in the figure the ratio of the two sides and two angles, and we are supposed to find angle P. Now, we know that triangle ABC and triangle PQR, if you observe, AB upon QR is equal to 3.8 upon 7.6, which is equal to 1 by 2. BC upon QP is 6 upon 12, that is again 1 upon 2. And CA upon PR is 3 root 3 upon 6 root 3, which is again equal to 1 by 2. So all the three sides, ratio of the three sides are in proportion. And by SSS similarity, it is a similarity. So automatically, angle C will be equal to angle P. And angle C is equal to 180 minus angle A minus angle B. So that is equal to 40. So angle P is equal to 40. Now let us take the sixth example. In the sixth example, we are supposed to prove OA into OB is equal to OC into OD. So OA upon OC is equal to OD upon OB. Also, we have angle AOD is equal to angle COB. Vertically opposite angle. Therefore, from 1 and 2, triangle AOD is similar to triangle COB, that is SAS similarity criteria. Therefore, angle A is equal to angle C and angle D is equal to angle B, corresponding angles of similar triangles. So, if that is automatically proved, we can get the result what we required. Now let us see the seventh one, which is an important question. Now, a girl of height 90 cm, her height is 90 cm. If I convert it into meters, then it is 0.9 meters. Which is equal to 0.9 meters. Is walking away from the base. This is the base. She is walking away from the lamppost at the speed of 1.2 meters per second. If the lamp is at a height of 3.6 meters from the ground, find the length of her shadow after 4 seconds. So, now let AB denote the lamppost, CD denote the girl. If I draw the triangle around it, I will find that I get a smaller triangle DEC and a bigger triangle BEA or AEB. And I have to find DE, which is represented by X. Now if I try to observe, then these two triangles are similar according to the similarity criteria. Then BD is 1.2 into 4, which is equal to 4.8, because we know that speed is equal to distance upon time. So distance is equal to speed into time, which is 1.2 into 4, that is 4.8. Therefore, this distance BD is 4.8 meters. And total distance BE is 4.8 plus X. Now if I try to observe, angle B is equal to angle D, 90 degrees, E is equal to E. So by AA criteria, it is a similarity. So I can take BE upon DE is equal to AB upon CD. If I replace the values, that is 4.8 plus X upon X is equal to 3.6 upon 0.9. As I converted meter into centimeter into meter here, I will get, after solving, X is equal to 6.8. That is the height of the shadow, or the length of the shadow of the girl is 6.8. Question 8. CM and RN are the medians of triangle ABC and PQR. That means BAM is equal to AM and QN is equal to PN. In triangle ABC and PQR, now we have to prove triangle AMC and triangle PNR are similar. CM upon RN is equal to AB upon PQ, and CM upon triangle CMB is equal to triangle, is similar to triangle RNQ. Now let us take the first one, that AB C is similar to triangle PQR. Now AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to CA upon RP. So angle A is equal to angle P, angle B to Q and C to R. And AB is 2AM and PQ is 2PM because they are the midpoints. Therefore, if I replace the value of AB upon PQ by 2AM upon PN, I get the relation as AM upon PN is equal to CA upon RN, and already this angle is equal. So by SAS criteria, these triangles are similar. Now if these triangles are similar, I can write the ratio as CM upon RN is equal to CA upon RP. But if I try to see, then CM upon RN is equal to half AB upon half PQ because they are the midpoints. If I remove this, I can replace CM upon RN in place of CA upon RP. That is, I get AB upon PQ. So this relation is also again proved, which is a required relation. Now AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR, and CM upon RN is equal to BC upon QR. So CM upon RN is equal to AB upon PQ is equal to 2BM upon 2QN. So CM upon RN is equal to BM upon QN. So CM upon RN is equal to BC upon QR is equal to BM upon QN. So according to this SSS criteria, this is a similarity. It is very clear from these examples how these criteria are useful to solve the various examples. Thank you.